Jason Tatum. Fresh off this weekend where he hit a game winner, his first game winner of the year where he actually aimed correctly and made it. He answers that with a 40-point performance. Jason Tatum, 40 ball, he gets the bronze. Who gets the silver?
Move him up a tier.
Giannis, don't look now, but the two-time defending MVP is red hot. 43-9 last night, averaging 33-12 over his last three games. Giannis gets the silver medalist and the gold medalist. Despite Wilds mocking his airball, oh, my large adult, slightly overweight Slovenian son, Luka, not in shape, yet still dropping 33, 16, 11 on people's heads, getting big wins over the Rockets. Luka is your gold medalist. Those are your three best performers of the night, Wilds.
Okay.
Can't be body shaming.
Do you feel like this was a defining win for the Mavs? Or in a defining loss for the Rockets, that it's time to like, Rockets and Mavs not on the same level, or no. Say, hey, it's regular season, we're still figuring it out.
No, I think it's too early. And Brandon, I think that for the Mavs, it was a more important game. Luka hadn't been playing great until this past couple. He just missed a game, they lost. Yep. And the Mavs are trying to be a top three seed in the West. They need to pile up wins, and Luka needs to play like an MVP. So I think it's more for the Mavs.
First, Brandon, you love Dre jumping around.
Yeah, listen, guys, I don't know why this is funny. Maybe you guys can help me out here, but this is Draymond Green, everybody. He's only played three games this year. He's back, and he's back to where he left off. This is Draymond Green yelling, screaming at his teammates to clear out, we gotta get the ball to Steph Curry. I don't know why I think this is funny. But it's
Brandon,
funny to me, guys.
Is he yelling at his teammates, or is he celebrating his first made basket of the year? I'm not sure. Because he didn't make a basket last
time. He has like 6 points on the season.
I'm not sure.
Why would you bring that up? He has like 6 points on the season. He's getting started.
Be nice. Nick. Oh, here we go.
Okay, look. Here, I'm going to give you some fashion advice, some recipe advice, mostly fashion advice. Sometimes you can do too much. You know what they always say? Like, take off one accessory before you leave the house. So if you got an outfit on, you got too much going on, just do one thing less. You'll be better off. Same with Luka here, Nick. Your adopted Slovenian son. Too much here. This last move there, airball. Too much. I think when you guys were working on the cobblestone streets of Slovenia, I feel like you taught him your enthusiasm for his prospects. You overdid it a little bit, and this is what happens. I don't know if you want to dial it back next time you guys meet or what your plan is.
Yeah, listen, one too many dream shakes there. A little too much. He was trying to be Akeem. They're playing the Rockets. I understand. It was an homage to the 11th greatest player ever, but he did too much. You're right. You're right. I'll talk to him. I'll talk to him about it. It's a good point. An homage to Akeem. I get it. It's a good point by you, Wilds. Oh, speaking of good points, good tweets. So the Sixers, my pick to go to the finals out of the East, they have the best record in basketball. They're 6-1. They're blowing folks out. Blowing folks out so much so, they don't got to play starters in the fourth quarter. Cue the tweet. So the Sixer, NBC Sports Philadelphia says, Sixers taking their starters out. No one tell the Giants. All of a sudden, random Twitter user, Giants fan in his avatar says, begging for interactions, I see. NBC Sports Philly says, we're not done here. Off the top rope, begging for the playoffs, we see. That, my friends, is good social media. Excellent job, NBC Sports Philly social media manager. That is well done.
So I'm watching the Miami Heat game last night. No, I wasn't, but I saw highlights this morning. And I see these uniforms, and I can only imagine the yin-yang conversation, the yin-yang pull in the R&D lab when they were coming up with these dumb colors. They were like, oh, we need to be fun and flashy and flamboyant, like a flamingo. No, we need to be serious and conservative and blue like the Eastern Conference champs. No, flamingo, Eastern Conference champs. Flamingo, Eastern Conference champs. What do? They go halvesies. I don't like halvesies. I don't like halvesies on cleats. I don't like halvesies on shorts. I don't even put half and half in my coffee. Make a decision, move forward. You want to be with the Lakers at the very end, still standing? Make a decision. This like half and half is going to get you absolutely nowhere.